All right, 25 Celsius, that's 77 Fahrenheit. It's a warm day out there. It ain't quite hot, but it's a warm day out there. Wind seems to be not bad. Completely overcast, like most of the time. Anyways, I finished watching Tales from the Loop, and it was a sad ending. It was kind of interesting, though. They're all like little short stories, but they're interrelated, and it's quite an interesting show. It's science fiction, sorta. There's all these things happening in the area because of the loop and the thing that's in the loop, and so it's kind of interesting, but it's alternate world type thing. But it's interesting. It's interesting. Then I watched the first three episodes, no, two episodes of season two of Afterlife, which is basically it's about a guy who's survived his wife's death, of course, and he's very sad about it. Whatnot, and it's him and his friends is what it's about, and people he knows, and it's really, it's an interesting show. It's funny as hell on some levels, and it's really kind of meaningful on another level. So it's interesting. It's interesting. I enjoy it. It's British, if that helps you. Know what kind of humor it is. He's in the care home visiting his dad, who's kind of out of it. And what does he say? What? Joe's dead? Lucky bastard. Oh, shit. Yeah. And he works for a newspaper, and they're interviewing this 100-year-old woman. And she's going on how shit life is, and how everything hurts, and she wishes she was dead, but she keeps waking up alive, and just fabulous interview. The Queen sent her a thing for her 100th birthday, and she's going on about how bad life is and whatnot. Furs. Not going to get up to much today except watching an absurd amount of television. Streaming mostly. I'm telling you, I watched an absurd amount of streaming last month, and I still only got 255 gigabytes of bandwidth used. I don't know, unless they've dialed down the quality or dialed up the compression ratio. I don't know, because it should have been more than that, because I watched an absurdly more amount of streaming than I have normally last month, so it should have been more than that. Did a little bit of fractal stuff yesterday, as usual, because I'm addicted to doing it. I love cranking those things out. I really do. I really do. Haven't done much Bryce work. Bryce is a 3D rendering software. It's an old one. It's not very spectacular in its results, but it's easy to use, and I have it. The modern high-end quality stuff is really very expensive. I mean, like as in used car expensive. So that's not going to happen anytime soon. Do have Poser, a newer version of Poser. It's not a new one, but it's a newer version of Poser. But I don't use it much. I just use it to pose the models, and then I export them, and I do them in Bryce. Anyways, got a thing called Xenodream, which is a sort of a 3D fractal thing. It's very primitive in retrospect, but it's It's one I paid for. I think I paid $20 for it years ago. But it's it doesn't export very well, the objects very well. Mendelbaum 3D doesn't export the objects very well either. They're very crappy exports as a 3D object. So importing them into another program to render is kind of pointless because of the quality. Yep, but I have had a few Zena Dream ones actually come out well enough that they look nice in Bryce. So I've had nothing come out well enough to import into Bryce on Mendelbaum 3D, though. I've pretty much given up on that. Yippers, yippers. I've got Mendelbaum 2.1 or whatever the hell. It's the latest version anyways. But I almost never use it. I've forgotten how to resize the render, how to make the render bigger, because it's the fixed size of the little preview window, and I don't know how to make it bigger anymore. I've forgotten. And I can't seem to figure it out because I can't find it anywhere how to make it bigger. So, oh, if I ever do, I'll do some more on that. But until then, I don't want to crank out these postage stamp size images. So, it's a way higher quality than Mendelbaum 3D, though. The images are photorealistic when you're done with them. They're very high quality. If you put the right skins on them, the right skins is the word, but what do you call that? Texture and color and all that stuff. But yeah, it's a nice program, but well, it takes a lot of power too because it's a slow render. I had to actually cranked out a couple of really nice big ones, I forget. I just forget. I can't find it by poking around, so I don't know where it is. So you would think it would be in the settings, but it's not. So unless I've overlooked it, yeah. Anyways, that's it. That's all. You all have a fabulous day and keep smiling. Oh yeah, I'm up 2 pounds. That didn't work very well, did it? Processed meat, mostly. Yippers. Anyways, have a good one.